Greetings and salutations, all you children of the galaxy. I'm Master Roshi 78, and welcome to the final real review of the year. And boy, am I excited for this one. And joining me in the review is my special guest star, R2-D2. Say hello, R2. Yeah, R2, that's right. Now, don't take it there, R2. Okay, that's enough, R2. Hey, my mother does not! let's get on with the review, shall we? And if you're a geek like me, you know just how much the Star Wars franchise has made an impact on the media world. With its galactic adventures and complex stories and riveting characters, it's been a staple in media for many, many years. That is until the prequels came out, then it sort of went a downward spiral. But it's been 10 years since that day, and we finally have a new Star Wars movie. And it's not directed by George Lucas. Thank you. This is the story of Star Wars: The Force Awakens. A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. By the way, I never got that. If it's supposed to be a long time ago and far, far away, how long ago is it? When does this take place? How far away is it? I think I'm thinking too much into this. It has been 30 years since the events of the Return of the Jedi, and everyone has gone their separate ways. Luke Skywalker has gone into exile, Han Solo has gone back to cruising the galaxy, and Leia Organa is still in command of the Rebel fleet, who now call themselves the Resistance. Because from out of the ashes of the Empire rose a new faction called the First Order, led by the sinister Supreme Leader Snoke, and co-led by the equally sinister Kylo Ren. An ace pilot and his faithful companion BB-8, who, by the way, is second to R2, the best droid ever, have found a map leading to the location of Luke Skywalker. When trying to get the map, Kylo Ren intervenes, trying to get the map for himself. Kylo Ren captures the ace pilot, leaving the BB-8 droid stranded on the planet of Jakku. While looking for some help, he finds a scavenger girl named Rey, and the two quickly become acquaintances. Meanwhile, on a brand new Death Star, yes, I'm serious, they actually made a new Death Star, a lone stormtrooper sees the evil that the First Order has done and quickly decides, I don't want to be a part of this crap anymore. So the stormtrooper breaks the ace pilot out and flies him back to Jakku. The ace pilot Poe quickly names the stormtrooper Finn, and the two become fast friends. When the stormtrooper crash lands on Jakku, he finds Rey and the BB-8 droid, and they quickly become acquainted, trying to bring the map to the location of Luke Skywalker to the Resistance before the First Order can get to it. And honestly, ladies and gentlemen, that's all I'm gonna say about it, because this movie is so chock full of surprises and great twists that you just have to see it for yourself. So what did I think of this movie? I loved it! Oh my god, this is such a good Star Wars movie! And after 10 years of a Star Wars movie, and 32 years of a good Star Wars movie, this was a fresh breath of air. I'm serious, I want you all to go see it, because it is so full of good sci-fi action, and witty humor, and great characters. Oh man, I can't wait for the next couple of movies. It's so cool. Okay, so I pretty much gushed enough about this movie, but were there any bad points in it? Well, yes, only a couple. One of the things is really not that bad, but still it's kinda bad. This movie kinda has a kickstand of nostalgia. So if you didn't watch the original trilogy, you probably won't get most of the humor in this movie. And that is kind of a downfall, but at the same time, if you saw the original trilogy, it's just something to laugh at. Another gripe I have with this movie is Kylo Ren. No, don't get me wrong, he's a freaking badass. When he wants to be, but other than that, he kinda comes off as a whiny child. And you know what? A lot of villains do that, but unless you have the balls to back it up, then you shouldn't do it. But fortunately, Kylo Ren does have the power to back it up. So yeah, if you're looking for a good sci-fi movie with action, character, and a lot of heart, this is the movie for you. Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens. I can't wait to see where it goes from here. What did you think of the movie, R2? Yes, yes, I like the scenes where you were in it too. Anyway, Master Roshi 78 gives Star Wars Episode 7, The Force Awakens, a 9.5 out of 10. Thank you all for watching my review and... Sorry guys, I know I should be happy about this, but I'm kind of not. Only because it's Christmas, and as you probably know if you watch my channel, I haven't really done anything Christmas related. I've just been so busy this year, and things have gotten in the way, and I'm really sorry, guys. I really wanted to do something Christmas-like, but I guess it just wasn't in the cards. I'm really sorry I let you all down. I think I should go now. Hey, R2, can you close up for me? R2? R2, where'd you go?
You know, I never realized it was such a bad little tree. It's not bad at all, really. Maybe it just needs a little love. Don't you think so, Chewbacca? Oh, I quite agree, R2. Master Roshi will be very surprised when he gets here.
What's going on here?
Oh, yes. Merry Christmas indeed, Master Roshi.
Aw, you guys. That is so thoughtful. Thank you guys so much for doing this for me. And thank you all for supporting my channel through this entire year. And I hope to do much more content, much more real reviews, much more fandubs, and much more awesome stuff in the future. So from all of us, to all of you, I wish you all the happiest of holidays.
Oh, splendid. Wonderful. The surprise worked. And I believe R2 has some fitting Christmas music to play. R2, if you would.
Hark the herald angels sing.
Glory to the newborn king. Peace on earth and mercy mild. God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations wide. Join the triumph of the sky. With angelic voice proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory.
Time to kick in the new year! Yay!
Next time, Kung Fu Panda 4.